Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon,
sir. Today, I'll take up with one more term, that is assets. Take out your notebooks. First, we'll take up with one more term, that is assets. Yeah. In your notebooks, all of you give the heading assets. After liabilities, all of you give the heading assets. Liability was the sixth term we have done, right? So, all of you write down in the fourth page, term number 7, that is assets. Now, asset is a very broad term. Asset is a very broad term and important term also. I will discuss with only some portion of assets in the current lecture and rest I'll discuss in the upcoming lecture. First of all, what is asset? Examples of assets we have been looking further also when we have done the transactions. Asset is anything or any resource or any item or any right which the business owns and has monetary value. Which the business owns and has monetary value. For example, machinery. Is machinery a resource or a thing or a property or a right which the business owns or not?
Yes, sir.
And does it have monetary value also or not?
Yes, sir.
That is called asset. Furniture is also an asset because business owns it and also it has monetary value. Okay. Then after furniture, car, building, machinery, air condition in the office, computer, MacBook, all these are examples of assets. Even goods are assets. This is an interesting fact. All goods are assets, but all assets are not goods. Goods, do the business own until they sell it or not?
Yes.
Do they have monetary value or not?
Yes.
So they are also assets, but all assets are not goods. Only those assets are goods which you buy and sell again and again. Do you understand this portion? So goods are assets, but assets all are not goods. Is everyone clear with it? So what is an asset? Yeah. All of you repeat, what is an asset? Any item.
Any item.
Or right.
Or resource.
Which business owns
and has monetary value.
Now understand this. At UWIL, we have several location or branches. How many location or branches do you have? How many centers do we have? Any idea?
Eight
centers, right? Out of that, 5 centers are owned by us. Means we have purchased those properties. Okay, do those 5 properties have monetary value?
Yes.
Do we own them?
Yes.
They are our assets. What about the rest of the 3?
Rented.
Okay, why do we have only 5 centers owned? What does that mean? That means remaining 3 we have taken on?
Rent.
Those 3 are not our assets. Those 3 are not our assets. Do you understand this difference now? So, what are the 2 necessary conditions for any item to be your asset? You must
own it.
Used in business.
Monetary value.
Monetary value.
Okay, further, it must be used in the business also. It must be used in the business also. Are you all clear with that? Furniture we use in the business. You purchase a car for your personal use. It is not an asset of the business. But if you purchase a car for business use, then that is an asset for the business. Is everyone able to understand this?
Yes, sir.
Okay, write down. Any item or right or resource which is owned by the business and what is the second condition?
Has monetary value.
Has monetary value.
Yes, has monetary value, is called asset. So is the term asset clear to every one of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay, write down. For example, okay, land. It's a property. Does the business own it? It's a resource which is owned by the business?
Yes.
And does it have monetary value?
Yes.
So that is an asset. Okay. Then after land, write down building. Furniture. Machinery. Cash. Is cash also an asset or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Cash, if you have you own that cash, and also does it have monetary value or not?
Yes.
Then bank balance is also your asset?
Yes, sir.
And what did I say? Goods are also your assets or not?
Yes.
And what did I say about the goods? All goods are?
But all assets are not goods.
So all of you note down that also. All goods are assets. But all assets are not goods. One classification of asset we will understand today. Only one classification of asset we'll understand for today. All of you write down classification of assets. As I said, asset will not understand in one lecture. Some part of assets will understand today and some part of assets will take up in the next lecture. So one classification of asset is fixed assets and current assets. Okay, one classification of assets is fixed assets and current assets. Now understand what is fixed assets and current assets. Understand it? See, all of you remember what is current liability and non-current liability?
Yes, sir.
What did I tell you is the thin line of distinction between current and non-current or short-term and long-term?
1 year.
1 year.
Anything which is less than 1 year is?
Short-term.
Short-term.
Or?
Current liability.
Current liability.
Current liability.
Anything which is for more than 1 year is?
Non-current liability.
Non-current liability.
Long-term. Long-term. Right? Now, same distinction in the assets also. What do you mean by the word fixed? In general, dictionary word, what do you mean by the word fixed? Raise your hand.
Always constant, remains. Always remains.
Yes, Paras, very good. Fixed means...
For example, land.
Yes, again very good. Fixed means something which does not change. It remains constant. It remains same. So, fixed assets are those assets which remain same, which remain constant years and years. They remain same, they remain constant for years and years. Okay? And they live in our business for more than 1 year period of time. As I told you, current and non-fixed assets are also called non-current assets. As I told you, non-current means something which has a lifespan of more than 1 year. Okay? So can you tell me out of these examples which I made you write, which all assets do you find would not change, they would remain same, and would have lifespan of more than 1 year?
Land.
Yes.
Machinery.
Building.
Machinery.
Machinery.
Building, machinery. What else?
Furniture.
Furniture. Will cash remain same every time?
No.
Will bank balance remain same every time or does it keep on changing?
It keeps on changing.
Remain same and do they remain in the business for years and years?
No.
Goods are something you buy to sell again and again. They are called current assets.
and wrong.
Which have a lifespan of less than 1 year. And fixed means they remain same. Current means they keep on changing. They do not remain same.
Same.
You have 200 rupees in your pocket every day.
No.
If you get the pocket money, you spend it also.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
At a point of time, you'll have 200. At a point of time, you'll have 50 rupees. At a point of time, you're the richest person in the world, you'll not have anything. Right? So, does the amount of cash keep on changing or not?
Yes, sir.
That is called current asset. Current asset means, number one, the lifespan is less than?
Year.
Like goods. They don't remain in the business for years and years. You buy it today, you'll sell it tomorrow. They may be there in your business for 1 day, 1 week, 10 days, maybe 1 or 2 months. But after that, they'll get sold off. Okay. Second characteristic of current asset, fixed assets remain same. These keep on changing. The amount of current assets in the business keeps on changing. Okay. And third, one more characteristic of current assets, if it is not cash in bank, it is easily convertible in cash. Whereas fixed assets are not easily convertible in cash. Is it easy to sell your land, property, building?
No.
You have to give advertisement in newspapers, hire agents. It takes a lot of time to sell it. Is it or not? But is it easy to sell your goods?
Yes.
Yes. Today you buy it, tomorrow it will get sold off. So can I say goods will easily get converted in cash or not?
Yes.
So they are current assets. What is one more characteristic of current asset? They easily get converted in cash. Okay, let's write it down so you'll understand it. In fixed assets, all of you write down. Number one. Those assets. Okay, fixed assets are also called
non-current assets.
Fixed assets are also called non-current assets. Okay. So, fixed assets means they are those assets which remain in the business for long period of time. What do you mean by long period of time?
More than 1 year.
And current assets means they are those assets which remain in the business for all of you
less than a year.
Yes, short period of time. So here, long period of time means more than 1 year. Short period of time means less than 1 year. Secondly, fixed assets means the amount remains. Fixed means?
Constant.
Constant. For years and years, the amount remains constant. Whereas current means the amount keeps on
changing.
Converted to cash.
The amount keeps on
changing.
The amount keeps on changing. And third characteristic, fixed assets, they cannot be easily
converted into cash.
They cannot be easily converted in cash. And over here, they can be easily converted in cash. Is this clear up till here, everyone?
Yes.
Okay. So, example. Land, building. Which other examples did we see for fixed assets?
Machinery.
Then, furniture. Vehicles, etc. Okay, they all remain in the business for a long period of time. The amount remains constant and they cannot be easily converted in cash. Whereas here we have seen, as if now, three examples: cash balance itself, bank balance, and goods. More terms when we come across further, then some more examples I will make you write over here. Is everyone clear with this? So all goods are
assets.
But all assets are
not goods.
Okay, keep this in mind, everyone.
Sure.
So this one term and one classification we have done today. Take out your homework examples. First, we discuss your homework answers. Now, purchase furniture from Santoshi Nakamoto Furniture Mart for ₹40,000. What comes in? First of all, is it a cash transaction or a credit transaction?
Credit transaction.
Because the name Santoshi is given, so it's a credit transaction. Okay, I'm discussing the answers of homework questions. What is the first question we have to ask? What comes in?
Furniture.
All of you, check your answer. Furniture comes in affects furniture account. Furniture comes in affects furniture account. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, second question, what goes out? Nothing goes out because it's a credit transaction. We have not paid the money. Which income? No income. Who is the giver?
Santoshi Nakamoto Furniture Mart is giver.
Yes, I'm writing in brief. Santoshi Nakamoto Furniture Mart is the giver. Okay, just check your answers from that. Now, that will affect which account?
Santoshi Nakamoto Furniture Mart account.
Okay. Yes, now purchase goods from Hardik for ₹60,000. So, first effect, what comes in?
Sir, it is a credit transaction.
Yes, correct. First of all, it's a credit transaction because the name Hardik is given. So, name Hardik is given means it's a credit transaction. Now, what comes in?
Goods comes in.
All of you check your answers, okay? Goods comes in. Affects which account?
Purchase account.
Now, when we get the answer to the first question, we need not ask the other questions. Second effect, what goes out is, does anything go out?
No.
Then second question, is there any income?
No.
So third question, who is the giver?
Hardik.
Hardik is the giver. And that affects which account?
Hardik's account.
Hardik is the giver, affects Hardik's account. Paid fire insurance premium of 13,000 for the shop. So what comes in?
Services.
First of all, it's a cash transaction because services involved.
Yes, sir.
We are taking the services of insurance company over here. Now, what comes in? Service comes in. So that leads to second question. Which expense is involved?
Fire insurance premium service expense.
Fire insurance premium is an expense. And that affects which account?
Fire insurance premium account.
Is everyone clear with that?
Yes, sir.
And second effect, what goes out?
Cash goes out.
Cash goes out affects which account?
Cash account.
Bought goods from Tiger. Tiger name is given.
Credit transaction.
Now, what comes in?
Goods comes in.
And that affects which account?
Purchases account.
So, are you all able to get this correct in the homework?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
And second effect, what goes out?
Cash Nothing. Goes out.
No, why cash will go out? It's a credit transaction, so cash cannot go out. Right?
Nothing goes yes. out.
Nothing goes out.
The tiger, tiger is the giver.
Yes.
Tiger is the giver.
Nothing is an income. Who is the giver? Tiger is the giver. Okay, tiger is the giver. Is everyone clear why cash cannot go out?
Credit transaction.
Yes, because it's a credit transaction. So, tiger's account. Now, again, purchase goods from Tony for cash. Now,
cash transaction.
Cash transaction. So, what comes in?
Goods comes in.
Affects?
Purchase account.
And? What goes out?
Cash goes out.
The cash transaction. So cash goes out affects
cash account.
So very necessary to first understand is it cash or credit transaction. Then only you'll be able to identify whether cash comes in or goes out or not. Sold furniture of 15,000 to Raj Furniture Mart clearly given on credit. So it's a
credit transaction.
Okay, it's a credit transaction. Now, what comes in?
Nothing.
Comes in.
Which
expense?
No expense.
Sir, Raj Furniture Mart is the receiver.
Is the giver.
Receiver.
We have sold furniture to him. So, Raj Furniture Mart is the receiver. Who is the receiver?
Raj Furniture Mart.
The receiver. Affects which account?
Raj Furniture Mart account.
Are you all clear with that? And second effect, what goes out?
Furniture goes out.
Furniture goes out.
Goes out.
Affects?
Furniture account.
We cannot assume that we are furniture mart owner. So we here assume furniture is goods. They are not assets. Furniture account. Okay. Sold goods of 12,000 to Sanjay again on credit period of 10 days. So it's a?
Credit transaction.
And again in a credit transaction, first effect, what comes in?
Nothing comes in.
Which expense?
No expense.
Who is the receiver?
Sanjay is the receiver.
Affect Sanjay's account.
Sanjay's account. And effect two?
Goods goes out.
Affects?
Sales account.
So till 19 was your homework, right? Now all of you understand this bank transactions. First of all of you take out 25th page of your this book which is given to you. Whosoever has collected the book, take out 25th page of your book. Now, what are these bank or check related transactions? First, you understand how does the check look like and what are its implications. Understand this. See, there are two types of checks. You don't have to write it in the notebook just for understanding. There are two types of checks. Which is this first one you can see over here? Bearer check.
What do you call it as?
Bearer check.
And what is the other one?
Account pay.
Understand what is the difference in bearer and account pay?
Yes, sir. Sir, so a bearer check is in which the money is to be given to the bearer who hands in the check. The account of the... Means the money is being given to the bearer who hands in the check, and in account pay, the money transfer is made from the person's account to the other person's account from its account transfer.
Again, you are quite close, but not exactly correct. See, I'll tell you now what is different. Account pay check is also called crossed check. What do you also call it as?
Crossed check.
Means, can you see this image of check in front of you?
Yes, sir.
Now, suppose over here I write pay to Dhruv. Can you all see this? I have written pay to Dhruv over here.
Yes, sir.
Dhruv Modi, and then I put this line over here, right? Now, there are two things possible. The check which is present in front of you is a bearer check. This check which is in front of you is which check?
Bearer check.
Suppose I write rupees 10,000 only. Okay. And then in figures also 10,000. And then here my signature is required. Correct? Now, bearer means what? You can go it, present it in the bank and encash it. You can go it, present it in the bank and encash it. Means Dhruv can go in the bank, give the check, bank will give cash to Dhruv and they will not even ask to him, are you really Dhruv Modi? They will not even ask him. Forget about Dhruv. Even if same check is taken by Kasturi and she goes and presents in the bank, bank will give that 10,000 rupees to Kasturi also. They will not even question her. You don't look like a Dhruv. They will not even question to her. So this is called bearer. You know, understand the word bearer. Whosoever bears the check will get the money. Whosoever has the check will get the money. It's very risky. If bearer check is lost, suppose I give this 10,000 check to Dhruv and it gets lost by him on the road. By mistake, the check gets fallen by him. And that check is taken by Neil. He can also go and collect the money. Bank will not question to him that you are Dhruv or not. Or show your Aadhaar card or show your PAN card. Whosoever has that piece of paper, bank will give the money. So bearer check is as good as cash. You can go to the bank. Which bank you'll have to go but over here?
Same bank.
HDFC Bank.
HDFC Bank, you will have to go. You'll present this check and they will give you cash rupees 10,000 over here. Did you understand this meaning of bearer check, everyone?
Yes, sir.
It is as good as currency note. Now coming to the second one. What is the second one, all of you?
Okay.
Now what we do in account pay is, in this top left hand corner, we make two lines parallel to each other. Can you see this?
Yes sir.
That's
yes,
why sir. I told you it is also called
crossed check.
Because do we make these two lines cross in the left hand corner, top corner or not?
Yes sir.
That is the reason yes, sir. Also called cross check. And in yes. between that you write account pay. In between that you write
account.
Now, if this portion is done by me, if I do this, then you cannot encash it in the bank. What you have to do, Dhruv?
Yes, sir.
You or your father maintains account in which bank?
Sir, HDFC.
HDFC itself. Okay. So, what Dhruv will do is, account pay means the money will be paid in his bank account only.
Bank.
He will deposit this check in his account and the bank will transfer the money from my account to his account. Okay. Suppose he has an account with ICICI Bank. Which bank?
ICICI.
He will deposit this check in ICICI Bank. ICICI Bank in turn will collect the money from HDFC Bank. Means they will take the money from HDFC Bank from my account and transfer it directly to which account? Dhruv account. This takes at least one day time. So if you go and deposit the check in the bank today, immediately you will not get the money in your account. You'll get the money in your account earliest next day. Did every one of you understand this portion?
Yes, sir.
This is called which check?
Account pay check.
Account pay check.
Cross check.
So, bearer check is as good as?
Cash.
Bearer check is as good as cash because anyone can go and collect the money from the bank, whosoever bears or has the check. Whether his name is written on that or not does not make any difference. And account pay means anyone cannot collect it because now this money will go only in whose account? Dhruv Modi's account. Whosoever's name is written on the check. Is every one of you clear with this?
Yes, sir.
Now, what are we supposed to do? Understand it. Whenever any check transaction comes in your question, whenever any transaction of check comes in your question, you always treat it as account pay check only. You always treat it as crossed check only. Okay? If any check transaction comes in your question, What will we always take it as?
Account payee
or cross check, until and unless it is specifically mentioned that it is a bearer check. Yes, now all of you understand how we are supposed to give the effects in bank transactions. Now, all of you write down this in your notebook. Bank transactions.
Sir, we have to write it in the terms page or after the worksheet?
In your notebooks, classwork notebooks.
No, sir. In the terms page, which we had left.
Not in the terms page. Write it in the fundamentals page.
Okay, sir.
Yes, be attentive. Bank transactions, whenever any check and deposited in the bank, what will be its effect? What will you do with the check if you receive it? You'll deposit it in the bank, is it or not?
Yes.
Effect will be bank is the receiver. What will be the effect for this?
Bank is the receiver.
Means that will give answer to which question of ours? Third question, that will give answer to which question of ours? Who is the receiver? Bank is the receiver. Is everyone clear with this?
Yes, sir.
And if check is given to someone, then that person will deposit the check in the bank?
Yes, sir.
Because we assume it is always an account payee check. Now, if he deposits in the bank, then will our bank pay the money to that person from our account or not? Yes or
yes,
no?
Yes.
So here we will say bank.
Yes, bank is the giver.
Here we will say bank is the giver. That again gives answer to which question of ours?
Who is the giver?
Who is the giver over here? Bank is the giver. And one more thing. When we say bank is the receiver, silly question, but when we say bank is the receiver, means who is the receiver? When we say bank is the receiver, who is the receiver?
We are
the receiver. So bank is the receiver means does not mean HDFC bank is collecting the money in its own pocket. HDFC bank is collecting the money in our pocket. Our pocket is our account in that bank. Our pocket means our account in that bank. So when we say bank is the receiver, we actually mean to say our account in the bank is the receiver. Whenever we say bank is the receiver, what do we mean by that?
Our account in the bank is the receiver.
And when we say bank is the giver, means does bank pay the money from its own pocket?
No.
Bank will give the money from our pocket, means from our account. So when we say bank is the giver, what does it actually mean?
Our account in
the bank is the giver. Did you all understand this?
Yes.
So that also you can mention over here. Bank means here our account in the bank. And here also bank means our account in the bank. Let us finish with worksheet 2. 20th transaction we have to continue with. All of you look at 20th transaction. Opened a current account with rupees 10,000 with ICICI Bank. New bank account is open. Effect 1. What comes in? Nothing comes in our business. We are depositing the money in the bank. In our business, nothing comes in. Okay? Is there any expense incurred?
No.
Who is the receiver?
Bank.
ICICI Bank.
Write down ICICI Bank is the receiver, affects ICICI bank account, or you can simply write bank account also. Second effect, what goes out if we deposit the money in the bank? What goes out?
Cash goes out.
Affects which account?
Cash account.
Non-economic transactions. Okay, placing an order means money is not involved right now. So it's a non-economic transaction. Placed an order on Automac Machinery Limited for machinery of 10 crore. When we buy that machinery of 10 crore, at that time it will result into an economic transaction. Right now, only order is given, so it's a non-economic transaction. Okay? Now, paid municipal tax of 2000, cash or credit transaction?
Cash transaction.
Because municipal services are being used and for that we are paying the money, so services involved. Okay? Effect 1, what comes in?
Service. Municipal taxes.
Service comes.
Expense.
Service comes in.
Service of municipality comes in. So that results into second question. Which expense is incurred?
Municipal tax account.
And effect 2. What goes out?
Cash goes out, affects cash account.
So cash goes out, affects
cash account.
Across the check. Now you understand what is this cross the check?
Yes, sir.
Of 20
account paycheck
from Abhishek. Now, what will we do with the check which we have received from Abhishek?
Give it to the bank.
So, bank is the
receiver.
Okay. So, do we get the answer of what comes in?
No.
In fact, check comes in, but that is not an effect because that check will come in and then immediately go in the bank. So, really, it does not come in our business. Okay. Any expense? No.
Who
is the receiver?
Abhishek.
Bank is the receiver. Abhishek is the giver. We have received from Abhishek. How can Abhishek be the receiver? He is giving us. He is the giver. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Check is received. We will deposit the check in the bank. So, bank is the receiver. Affects which account?
Bank account.
And, yes, who is the giver?
Abhishek is the giver.
So, first of all, do you get the answer of what goes out?
No.
Do you get the answer of which income? No. But do we get the answer of who is the giver? Yes. Abhishek is the giver. Abhishek's account. Now, 24th. Bearer check of 35,000 was received from Ruchi.
Cash comes in.
Yes. Bearer check is as good as?
Cash.
Can you all see here?
Yes, sir.
And we have written also that if it is received, it will affect which account? Cash. So write down, what comes in?
Cash comes in.
Because what will we do if we receive the bearer check?
Bank and get cash.
Deposit in the bank.
Go to the bank and take the cash?
Yes.
So that's why we will say cash comes in. Do you understand this? Now, what goes out?
No answer.
Nothing. Which income?
Nothing.
Who is the giver?
Ruchi.
Ruchi gives.
Ruchi is the giver. Affects Ruchi's account. Is that clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
What do you mean by dividend?
Sir, dividend means basically when a company earns a certain amount of profit, it gives the amount that is given on each share.
Okay.
That is increased. It means 25 rupees on each share is that dividend.
Okay, correct. Now, see, if I talk about our business, then we have partners. We five are the partners over there. Okay, so five owners are there of a business. But if I talk about a joint stock company, how many owners are there in a joint stock company?
Sir, whoever buys the share.
From the stock market. Whosoever buys the share is the owner of that company. So can I say there are thousands and lakhs of owners of a joint stock company?
Yes.
Like who is the owner of Reliance Industries Limited?
Mukesh Ambani and the people who buy shares.
Yes, even I am the owner of Reliance Industries Limited because I have few shares of Reliance Industries Limited. Every shareholder is the owner of that company. Did you understand this portion? Now, who is entitled to get the profits of any business?
The shareholders.
Shareholders.
Owners. Who is entitled to get the profits of any business?
Owners.
Like just now I said, in our class, five people are the owner. So who is entitled to get the profits of our business? We five.
Yes, sir.
Same way, who is entitled to get the profits of a company?
Shareholders.
Shareholders are the owners. Now, how will the company give the profit to these so many shareholders? They will have to distribute the profit to these every person or not?
Yes, sir.
That amount is called a dividend. So what is dividend? The amount of profit which is distributed between its shareholders is called a dividend. All of you repeat, the amount of profit.
The amount of profit.
The amount of profit.
Which is distributed.
Which is distributed.
Amongst the shareholders.
Among the shareholders.
Is called dividend.
It's called dividend.
What is this dividend for us? Income. You make investment in the shares of any company, on that you receive dividend. You keep the money in your bank fixed deposit. What do you earn return on that?
Interest.
Interest. Same way, if you invest the money in shares, what is the return you get on that?
Profit.
Profit.
Dividend. You invest the money in bank deposits, you earn interest. You invest the money in shares, what is the return you get on that?
Dividend.
Is everyone clear with it? From shareholders' point of view, what is that dividend? It is an income. From shareholders' point of view, what is that dividend? It is an
income.
Is that clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
So let us write this in the terminologies. Take out the terminologies page. A term dividend. The amount of profit distributed amongst the shareholders is called dividend. Is this clear to every one of you?
Yes, sir.
It is, for us, it is a return on investment in shares. It is a return on investment in shares. And therefore, it is an income. Is that clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so all of you try these questions in homework. Worksheet 2's remaining questions means up to 30. Which questions will you try in homework?
25 to 30.
And in the beginning, I will discuss its answers tomorrow. Okay? So that will be all for today. And these you'll try in homework by Thursday. They are a little bit complicated. Don't worry. I'll be discussing the answers on Thursday, so you'll understand these concepts. Okay? Chalo, bye everyone.
Bye. Bye, sir. Have a nice day.
Bye, sir.
Same to you. Have a nice day. Bye.